grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace.
It's time for another program of Despierta. My name is Carlos de Luna, and I have a topic that I would like to start off with. I'm going to try to be bilingual in this program. I will name a gentleman, a pastor, a friend of mine. His name, Manuel Rios. He passed the last days of October. He was a pastor and he was a friend of mine. I will never forget him. I started my individual ministry around 2012, and that was the last time that I worked with him. But I really enjoyed him as a pastor and as a friend. Le damos la bienvenida al programa. Mi nombre es Carlos García de Luna y soy ministro de la Palabra de Dios. Pero al mismo tiempo, este día le voy a dedicar un tiempo a un pastor y amigo, Manuel Ríos, que pasó a mejor vida, pasó a la presencia del Señor los últimos días de octubre. Un señor que luchó mucho en la fe, no era no nació en los Estados Unidos, nació en Perú. Pero una cosa, él nos enseñaba qué Biblia usar. Siempre, cada domingo, cada miércoles, él estaba ahí en su púlpito. A pesar que más o menos como unos 20 años platicando, me dijo, ay, hermano de Luna, estoy cansado. Y eso era hace como 20 años, pero él siguió adelante. Y uno de los cantos favoritos que a él le gustaba es, yo te sirvo. Un canto favorito de él. Y por la gracia de Dios, me dieron el anuncio que había pasado a mejor vida. Y quise traer un momento de tiempo para él. El hermano pastor Manuel Ríos, uno de sus favoritos versículos que nos enseñaba era Juan 3:30. Yo debo de hacerme menos y que Dios crezca en mí. Juan 3:30 en la Biblia, nos los enseñaba. Y lo voy a leer ahorita aquí en español. Juan 3:30, mejor de leerlo que yo decirlo, es necesario que él crezca, pero que yo mengüe. Es mejor que él crezca en mí y yo sea menos, decrease. Muy interesante ese señor pastor junto con su esposa. Tuve el honor de invitarlo a ese pastor cuando me jubilé yo del correo, que ahorita es el 7 de octubre, de diciembre, y el último día de diciembre del año, de este año 2022, me jubilé ya 12 años del correo. Y a él y a su esposa, y a una hermana también, amiga de ellos, los invité. Habré dentro del correo de la post office, un honor muy grande, porque nadie sin permiso puede entrar a una a un correo, a Brentro, allá donde se trabaja todo el correo. Y me dio el honor de invitarlo y él estuvo presente y tengo fotos cuando él estuvo en mi presencia ahí, cuando me dieron mi certificado de retiro del correo. Y en el nombre del Señor, le dediqué estos minutos a este pastor. Me acordé de un versículo en Galatas 4:11, para los que se van a, los que se quedaron ahí en esa iglesia donde el pastor Manuel Ríos era pastor. Para los líderes que quedaron ahí, mire lo que dice Gálatas. El apóstol Pablo escribió esto. Gálatas 4:11 dice: me temo de vosotros que haya trabajado en vano con vosotros. El apóstol Pablo escribió Gálatas 4:11. Me temo de vosotros que haya trabajado en vano con vosotros. Ustedes que quedaron en esa congregación son los líderes. Ustedes tienen que cuidar esa congregación. Esa congregación, con la ayuda del Espíritu Santo, el hermano Manuel Ríos levantó esa congregación a como existe hasta este segundo. Ustedes líderes, ustedes saben quién son y dónde está esta iglesia ahí. 2300 Bessie, Monte Calvario, Iglesia Bautista. No dejen a nadie que entre, porque es muy fácil entrar y agarrar un púlpito y estar hablando de la Biblia o Biblias. Muy fácil eso. Vivirlo es lo difícil. Yo le digo esto de casi 35 años en este libro. Una bendición es que el Espíritu de Dios lo guía para que esté parado en esos púlpitos miércoles o domingo durante la semana enseñando clases. Solo que los líderes de ese lugar, 2300 Bessie, pónganse muy aguzados, porque el diablo ahí va a andar. Cuidado con las ideas que quieren entrar. Para el año 2050, la mayoría de nosotros no vamos a estar aquí, pero va a haber tantas leyes que ahorita, si usted viera atrás de las noticias que no enseñan, si usted viera lo que están pasando leyes ahorita para cambiar lo de la Biblia, grupos que atacan de lo que está escrito en la Biblia. Pero así dice que va a pasar. Puse énfasis en este versículo, Gálatas 4:11. Cuiden que no pierdan lo que han sido enseñados ahí en ese lugar, 2300 Bessie. Una de las cosas que se está llegando hoy en día es el tiempo de la Navidad. Ahora voy a tratar de decir esto en inglés. I'm giving some word of thought to a group of believers at 2300 block of Bessie. I said in Spanish that a pastor friend of mine, he worked at 2300 block of Bessie, Monte Calvario Baptist Church, for years. And one of the things that I'm leaving you with this verse, Galatians 4:11. I am fearful for you that perhaps my labor for you have been wasted. The Apostle Paul gave us that verse because he was having problems with those believers in Galatians. He had gone there earlier in his time and spoken about biblical items. But he was getting worried that perhaps his labor that he did there has been wasted. And that's the same thing for any congregation that has had a pastor for a long time. All that effort that was placed, all that training, all that teaching that was done, don't let it go to waste. You, the leaders that are left at Monte Calvario Baptist Church at 2300 block of Bassey, you are the leaders now of that congregation. Keep those doors tight. Be careful what you hear. Be careful what you listen, because Satan will pop up and will try to destroy that congregation one way or the other. You all have to be real careful and keep teaching the doctrine that you all have been taught. It's real easy to get a Bible, read it, notes and all this and all that, and get on a pulpit and start talking about the Bible. But let me tell you, after 35 years plus, it has not been easy. The more you study, the more problems you're gonna get. And that's common knowledge. When Christ started his ministry, Matthew 4 tells us that Satan came and attacked them. And Jesus defended himself by telling him about the scripture, about the Bible. Even though Satan quoted him the Bible, but Satan quoted one verse incorrectly. You'll find all that information in Matthew chapter 4. So those leaders at 2300 block of Bassey, be very careful, because Satan has sent demons, spirits around that place. We understand that within 50 years from today, December the 7th, 2022, 50 years from today, most of the churches will be out of business. Bibles will no longer be copied. I made a list of 55 Bibles, versions of the Bible online. 55, imagine. I have here a Spanish 1960 and an English ESV. And it's going to get terrible. Being now the time of Christmas and all this holiday season coming up here, because like I said, today is December the 7th, 2022. But it's interesting to remember December the 7th, 1941. Unless you have any military involvement in your own life, believe me, if you see a war movie, if you see history on December the 7th, it really will not sink in. It's like my wife explaining to me how childbirth happens. I'll hear her. I will hear her. But I'll never understand the pain that goes through it. It's the same thing for us veterans, military veterans, that spent time in infantry units when we were 18 years old. The experience, the shock, the explosions, the running and screaming, and it's a lot different in being in real combat than just hearing or listening. And that's why on December the 7th, if you're a citizen of the United States, you should know about what happened on December the 7th, 1941. The respect for all those military and civilian personnel that their lives were taken. Today, December the 7th, 2022, I'm pretty sure here in San Antonio, there's not too much activities, maybe at the military bases, but other than that, through the years, it has been really dying. But for some of us that were in military, we really understand how and why things happened and the way that it did. We're thankful also for our scriptures that we still have the opportunity to read them. One of the things is there will be a lot of peace, the word peace mentioned. When we read the scriptures, you know, Jesus, according to millions, was supposed to bring peace. And I'm talking Jewish, to the Jewish people. He told them, I didn't come to bring peace. Even though when he was born, there's a Bible verse here in Luke 2:14, glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to people he favors. To people he favors, according to this Bible, the ESV. He did not come to bring peace. There's a verse here in Luke 12 that it's not read in churches because I really don't know why, but let me read it to you. I came to bring fire on earth, and how I wish it were already set ablaze. But I have a baptism to be baptized with, and how it consumes me until it is finished. And then here he goes. Do you think that I came here to give peace to the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, five in one household will be divided, three against two, and two against three. And he starts talking about the division he's going to do within a family. And since the beginning of time, within the scriptures, we find that there was no peace. But it's nice to hear that the peace here and peace there. And don't say it too loud, but if you go online and see what the Pope is doing. Oops, what did I say? Pope is doing. Google the peace he's trying to do with a lot of religious leaders from the around the world in Mount Sinai. He's there. If you can Google all that information, trying to bring peace. According to the Bible, Jesus said, I didn't bring peace, and I'm not going to bring peace. He brought division. And interesting about all this is nobody talks about it. Right now, on December the 7th, 2022, if we can walk around the malls, it is packed full of shoppers and some of them would care less about December the 7th. Some of them would care less about the Bible, but it's a book that is sold a lot. And it's a blessing to read and understand the Bible. This, I'm going to read in Spanish. I'm coming out of a cold, and on Luke 12, Luke 12:51. ¿Piensas que he venido para traer paz en la tierra? Os digo, no, sino disensión. ¿No trajo Dios paz a este mundo? Y si usted quiere encontrar paz, pues nos tenemos que morir. Y es cuando vamos a estar en la eternidad y tener paz. Pero mientras aquí en la tierra la Biblia nos dice no va a haber paz. Aunque ahí viene el tiempo de la Navidad y que paz para acá y que la paz y paz. No. Cuando andábamos en el servicio militar, nosotros, lo estudié también en la guerra número 2. Pero cuando andábamos nosotros en Vietnam, ahora el 25 de diciembre, me acuerdo que dijeron que se iba a parar el pleito y todo por el 25 de diciembre y así pasó. En la guerra número 2 ha habido fotos donde el enemigo, Estados Unidos, se sentaba con el alemán platicando porque había una paz de ciertas horas, pero que se acababan esas horas y ya regresaban para atrás a matarse uno al otro. Y eso es lo interesante de la paz. Nos dice la Biblia que Mateo, en Mateo 10, del 5 al 6, Mateo capítulo 10, versículos 5 y 6, Dios vino a los judíos. En Mateo 15, 24, Dios vino a los judíos. We read in the scriptures where in Matthew 10, verses 5 to 6, Jesus came to the Jews. Matthew 15:24 came to the Jews. Romans 15:8, Jesus came to the circumcised people, which were the Jews. He came, that was his mission. And it's interesting that when we read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, there's a lot of Old Testament involved in those books. Now, Satan has gotten through that and has said, well, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are all Old Testament material, Old Testament books. There's certain truth to that. But when you read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, there's a lot of studying in those books for Old Testament. There's a lot of information for future, and I mean future, and there's a lot of information for the present today. You have to divide it. You have to understand. But there's a lot of churches that all they do is teach Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. They forget to read 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18, where there's going to be a trumpet, and those in the body of Christ, those that have been born again, are leaving. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, all those verses on Christians marrying Christians, you never hear sermons on that. Corinthians chapter 5, where a sinner was in church and they didn't know what to do with him, the Apostle Paul wrote, 1 Corinthians chapter 5, he said, get him out of there. Let Satan take care of him, because his soul is safe. Read all that. Today, the time has gone by so fast that I had a topic here that would have lasted an hour. But time consuming, time is running fast. But I again want to say a thank you to have known Manuel Ríos. Le damos la honra y la gloria a Dios por haber conocido al pastor Manuel Ríos, a mi amigo Manuel Ríos, y un privilegio de haber trabajado ahí en su congregación. Nunca nos apartaremos de lo que él nos enseñó, y su versículo favorito era Juan 3:30. Nos quedamos que también los que quedaron en esa congregación, cuídenla, ámenla y sigan predicando a Cristo, sigan cantando los cantos, se miran muy bien en sus programas en televisión, pero cuiden esas puertas porque Satanás está preparando espíritus diabólicos, porque así es, así lo ha sido. Leemos en el libro de Éxodos, en el libro de Deuteronomio, cómo la gente se les olvida de lo de la Biblia, creyentes cristianos, y dejan entrar pensamientos que comienzan a destruir obras. En el nombre de Cristo les habla Carlos García de Luna. Algo que es de mucho interés hoy en este día, diciembre 7 del 22.
grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first found, was blind, but